Hi, I'm Avdhut Patel, application engineer working with Nokar Robotics Private Limited. In this video, we are going to demonstrate Nokar V310, an advanced ICU ventilator. V310 is powered by turbine-based technology that eliminates the requirement of compressed medical air and allows it to be used in several infrastructural setups. V310 has all standard non-invasive and invasive modes along with advanced modes for weaning, lung regroupment and lung protective ventilation for adult and pediatric patients. V310 also incorporates 8 hours of battery backup, high flow oxygen therapy mode among other exceptional features. It is tested and certified by international laboratories and it complies with requirements set by Government of India. Nokar V310's compact turbine based and power efficient design enables it to operate without compressed medical air or compressor, making it ideal choice for various kinds of ICU setups as well as intra-hospital transport. The integrated 10-inch touchscreen provides great monitoring and controlling capabilities along with seamless navigation between features through its user-friendly design. On the rear side of the ventilator, red main power switch and green ventilator switch are provided along with the high pressure dry oxygen port on one side and the air outlet port on another side. On the right side, ambient air inlet port is provided from where standard filter can be fitted. On the front side, the 10-inch touchscreen is provided below which we have the inspiratory and expiratory ports. Nokar V310 comes with best-in-class performance, providing peak inspiratory pressure up to 60 cm of water and tidal volume from 50 ml to 2000 ml. In this video, we are going to learn how to set up V310 and how to turn on and off the ventilator. Nokar V310 is mounted on stand. Patient circuit holder is provided to attach patient circuit. First step is take pressure regulator. Fasten the pressure regulator at high pressure dry oxygen port. Use two 1821 mm spanners for proper fitment of pressure regulator. Use 18 mm spanner side at ventilator's connector. Use 21 mm spanner side at regulator connector. Ensure pressure regulator is connected firmly. Connect the oxygen inline filter to inlet of pressure regulator. Ensure this arrow mark should be towards ventilator. Ensure oxygen inline filter is connected firmly with pressure regulator. Next step is buckle the oxygen hose ferrule connector on oxygen inline filter. Use spanners 18 mm side at oxygen inline filter's inlet. Use spanners 21 mm side to tighten the oxygen hose pipe. Ensure oxygen pipe is firmly connected. Plug single phase 3 wire cable at power socket. Plug a standard 22 mm male HME filter at air inlet manifold. User can use HME, HEPA or bacterial filter at this port as per ICU conditions. Connect active exhalation valve at expiratory manifold. Always ensure the flow direction should be towards ventilator. Connect silicone tube provided with standard kit between exhalation valve port and active exhalation valve active exhalation valve is used to maintain patient's PEEP, that is positive end expiratory pressure. The active exhalation valve connected with V310 is reusable one. Users can use this active exhalation valve on multiple patients after doing autoclave every time. Connect one HME filter at inlet of active exhalation valve. This filter will help to avoid secretion coming from patient side. It will help to increase the life of active exhalation valve. Connect patient circuit to inspiratory to expiratory port as per patient type. Currently, I am using adult patient circuit. Connect one limb to inspiratory port. Connect another port at filter connected in expiratory line. Attach the patient circuit to patient circuit holder. Connect artificial test lung at Y connector provided with patient circuit. Plug in standard 22mm HME filter in air outlet provided at V310's rear side. In this video, we are going to see how to turn on and turn off the NOCAR V310. Plug in standard single phase 3 wire cable into power socket. Switch on the main switch. Switch on the ventilator switch provided on other side. After switching on main switch and ventilator switch, we need to turn on UI screen. To turn on UI screen, display button is provided on the right side of display. Press and hold for few seconds to turn on the UI screen. When UI screen is turned on, one prompt will be appear on the screen. It shows screen is pinned. Always press on got it when this prompt come on screen. This process shows NOCAR V310 is turned on properly. In the left top corner of screen, blue indication of Bluetooth mark ensures the perfect serial communication. To turn off NOCAR V310, press and hold display button provided at right side of the screen. Prompt will be appear on the screen. Press on power off and press on OK. After turning off UI screen, switch off the ventilator switch. Keep main switch on for charging of the battery. If user wants to keep V310 on standby more than 12 hours, in that condition, switch off the main switch. We have seen that how to keep V310 on standby. While keeping V310 on standby, if user only switch off the ventilator switch and UI screen is not turned off, in that condition, the battery of UI screen will be discharged. It results in slow working of UI screen when ventilator will be used next time. For that reason, user always need to ensure that the UI screen and the ventilator switch is in off condition while keeping V310 on standby. In this video, we are going to see graphic user interface management. It consists of 10-inch UI screen which wirelessly communicate with main control board. It provides access to ventilator control and patient data. It consists of TFT screen which can be controlled using even surgical gloves. On the left side, there are three buttons. First one is plus minus volume rocker and GUI power button. By using this plus minus volume rocker, we can change the alarm volume, and by using this power button, we can on off UI screen. GUI battery is charged via USB cable coming from main control board. User always have to ensure that this should not be unplugged in any condition. When the ventilator is on, this will be your home screen. On the top bar, various buttons such as admit patient, change mode, status are given. On the top left side, patient name, patient ID, serial communication indication, time and date are displayed. At the center of the screen, start ventilation button is provided. Here you can see previous button is provided. When ventilator is on standby, it will be displayed on home screen as a standby and patient not ventilated. Nokar V310 can store data of up to 10 patients for more than 48 hours. To enter patient details, press on admit patient on top bar. Select the input field and it will open a keyboard. Here you can put the name of the patient. Then you can enter the patient ID. Press on anywhere on the screen. Then you can put the details of patient such as birth date, admit date, height and weight. After giving all the inputs, press on accept. It will be saved in the patient history. To check the saved data, again press on admit patient, then press on patient history. Here you can see the name we have given the input, then patient ID has been displayed on the screen. If we press on this info, it will open a screen. Now let's check what are the features provided in change mode option. I will press on change mode. Here you can see company has provided invasive and non-invasive ventilation modes. For invasive, total 11 modes are provided, and for non-invasive, 3 modes are provided, including integrated HFOT, that is high flow oxygen therapy. If you look at invasive modes, continuous mandatory ventilation, assist control, and synchronous intermittent mandatory ventilation can be operated as volume control, pressure control, and pressure regulated volume control. For non-invasive, company has provided CPAP, NIV-APRV, and HFOT. To set any ventilation mode, tap on the desired mode. I will select volume control, continuous mandatory ventilation. Then next window will appear, that is your set ventilation mode. When we select CMV in volume control, then set ventilation mode window will be appear. Here you can see VC-CMV, then I to E ratio and some basic settings such as tidal volume, RR, PEEP, that is your positive and expiratory pressure, and FiO2 parameters are displayed on the screen. To change any parameter, press on that particular parameter. Let's say I want to change the tidal volume. I will press on this VT. Now you can change the parameter by using this slider or by using these buttons. Accept it. Similarly, you can change other parameters. to set FiO2, press on FiO2. If you directly want to set FiO2 at 100%, take this slider directly to 100% and accept it. Once all parameters have been set, press on the accept. The next window will be your alarm profile. Here you can set the lower limits and upper limits for the particular parameters, including pressure, tidal volume, respiratory rate, FiO2 and peak. According to the set parameters, you have to set the lower limit and upper limit for that particular parameters. When we accept the set ventilation mode window, the next window will be alarm profile. User has to compulsory set the alarm profile while selecting or switching to the new ventilation mode. This is for safety reasons. While the user can also change the alarm values when patient is being ventilated by tapping on the alarm profile button. In the alarm profile window, the lower limits and upper limits are provided for parameters such as pressure, tidal volume, respiratory rate, FiO2 and peak. Here we have to set the limits as per the set values. We have set tidal volume 350. So I will set the lower limit for tidal volume 50% less than set value, that is 300 mm, and upper value 50 mm more than set value. Similarly, we will set the lower limits and upper limits for RR, FiO2 and peak. After accepting alarm profile, home screen will again appear. In the top bar, you can see the selected ventilation mode will be displayed. In the bottom bar, all the set parameters will be displayed. We will press on start ventilation. Here you can see ventilation has been started in volume control, continuous mandatory ventilation. Current ventilation mode will be displayed on the left side. On the screen, you are able to see three graphs. First one is pressure graph, second one is flow graph, and third one is volume graph. These three graphs are with respect to time. These are scalar graphs. But company provided loops also. In the right side, if you press on these loops, you are able to see the loops for each cycle. In loops option, we have provided volume pressure, flow pressure and flow volume. To close this window, in the left bottom, press on close. Then again, scalar graphs will be displayed on the screen. In the monitor parameter, first parameter is PIP, that is peak inspiratory pressure. Second one is PEEP, that is positive end expiratory pressure. Third one is PEEP plateau. Then inhalation tidal volume, exhalation tidal volume, FiO2 percentage, respiratory rate, eyes to E ratio. Nokar V310 comes with some additional values also.
To check additional values, press on these additional values. On the next window, you are able to see minute exhale ventilation, minute inhale ventilation. These two parameters are in the liter. Then spontaneous minute ventilation. This parameter will be used at the time of spontaneous breathing. Then leakage volume. Nokart V310 comes with auto leak compensation feature. If system is having any kind of a leakage, that will be displayed here. To simulate leakage condition, I will remove the knob given on the active exhalation valve. Now patient tube from inspiratory to expiratory is having leakage. On the graph you can see leakage is displayed. Similarly, in the leakage volume parameter, what amount of leakage is there will be displayed. On the same time, patient disconnected alarm will come on the screen. Press on OK. When leakage is restored, in the leak volume parameter, it will again show 0. The next parameter is RSBI, that is Rapid Shallow Breathing Index. This parameter is very important at the time of extubation. Next is static compliances and dynamic compliances. Inhalation time, exhalation time, and the average pressure will be displayed at the bottom of this window. If you want to check the previous parameters, again press on these additional values. On the right side of the ventilator, first option is alarm history. To check patient's alarm history, press on this alarm history button. In this window, you can check up to 200 alarms, including date, time, and the alarm. You can scroll up to check the older alarms. To close this window, press on this close button. If ventilator is used in emergency condition and user was not able to set the alarm profile during starting the ventilation, you can change the alarm profile by pressing this alarm profile button in the live operation. Select the parameters you want to change and accept it. Similarly, you can change all parameters. After setting the parameters, press on accept. The third option is additional features. If you press on this additional feature button, it will open the window in which expiration hold and inspiration hold option has been provided. First, we will see the inspiration hold. Inspiration hold simulates the condition of simultaneous closing of inspiration and expiration valves. It extends the inspiratory phase of single mandatory breath for the purpose of measuring plateau pressure and lung compliances. Pressure on either side of the artificial airway is allowed to equilibrate, which determines the pressure during no-flow state. To perform an inspiratory hold, we need to press on this inspiration hold. In the graph section, here you can see inspiration hold has been performed. And in the flow graph, here you can see there is a no flow state during inspiration hold. Inspiration hold will be stopped automatically after 10 seconds. Now we will see expiration hold. Expiration hold extends the expiratory phase of the current breath for the purpose of meaning intrinsic positive end expiratory pressure. It has no effect on the expiratory phase of the breath. During the expiration hold, the pressure on either side of the artificial airway is allowed to equilibrate, which determines the pressure during no flow state. To perform expression hold, press on start. To perform expression hold, press on start button. In the graph section, you can see expression hold is being performed and there is a no flow state in the flow graph. After 10 seconds, it is automatically off and normal ventilation has been started again. To close this additional feature window, press on close. Next feature provided by company is waveform scale. If you look at PIP, that is peak inspiratory pressure, is 60, but in the waveform scale of pressure graph is up to 80. Similarly, targeted volume is 350, but in the graph it is showing up to 800. To observe graph on maximize scale, press on waveform scale. It will open a window in which you can change pressure scale, flow scale, volume scale, and in addition to that, you can also change the time scale. I want to change pressure scale. I will press on manual, and according to my requirement, I will set it to 30. Similarly, I want to change the flow scale. I will press on manual. For flow, the readings are provided from negative to positive. The reason behind it, during expiration, flow will go in the negative values. So I will change accordingly as per my requirement. I will accept it. Similarly, I will change the volume scale by pressing on this manual button. My targeted volume is 350, so I will keep it at 450. I will accept it. Similarly, we can change the time scale as per the requirement. After setting the waveform scale parameters, press on close. Now you can check the waveforms on the maximize scale. It will help user to analyze each and every cycle of ventilation delivered to the patient. If you want to set waveform scale to default settings, press on waveform scale, and in pressure scale, flow scale and volume scale, in the green mark, auto set option is provided. Press on that auto set. Time scale we have to change manually. Close the window. Here you can see the graphs are displayed on the default waveform scale settings. In Nokar V310, additional settings for any ventilation mode is provided by the option named as additional setting on ventilator's right bottom side corner. To change additional settings, press on this additional settings. It will open a window. In this window, whatever the additional settings provided for that particular ventilation mode will be displayed. Volume control continuous mandatory ventilation mode has IS to E ratio as additional settings. To change these settings, press on this R. You can change by using this slider up to 6.0. Nokar V310 comes with IS to E ratio as 1:6 and 6:1. As per requirement, you can change it. I will keep as default settings. Similarly, you can change E I will keep it at 2.0. As per change in the value of R is to E ratio, in the left top corner of UI screen, it will be displayed in the form of seconds, TI and TE, that is your inhalation time and exhalation time. Once additional settings are set properly, press on this close button. In the monitor parameter, you can check the I to E ratio. Nokar V310 comes with excellent safety feature. As a part of safety feature, on the top bar, lock screen option is provided. If I press on hold this lock screen, screen will be locked. When screen is locked, there will be no input will be taken by the screen. This will prevent accidental changes on the screen. To unlock screen, again press and hold on this unlock screen button for 2 seconds, then screen will be unlocked. Now you can operate the screen. To stop the ventilation, on the top bar, standby option is provided in the red color. Simply press on the standby. One prompt will be appear on the screen, written as, do you want to stop ventilation, and go to standby mode. If you press on yes, it will stop the ventilation and home screen will be appear. In this video, we are going to perform preview check on Nokar V310. Preview check is a short and simple sequence of tests that verifies proper operation of ventilator hardware and performs sensor calibration. Before performing the test, we have to ensure that patient is not connected to the ventilator and all the HME filters connected to the ventilator should be removed. To start preview check, press on this preview button and follow the instructions coming on the screen. First instruction is, please turn off the oxygen supply. We have disconnected oxygen supply from main oxygen line, so I will press on yes. Next is, please turn off the mains power from the wall socket. So I have disconnected the external power, so I will press on OK. Next instruction is, please confirm if you hear the buzzer tone. I am able to hear the buzzer tone, so I will press on yes. Next is, please remove the exhalation valve tube from the port. So this is your exhalation valve tube port. So I will remove this tube from this port. Then I will press on OK. Please confirm if air comes out from the expiration valve tube port. So I can feel there is air coming out of this port. So I will press on yes. Now we have to remove the circuit and all filters to proceed the next test. I will remove the patient tube from inspiratory and we have already removed the HME filters from the ventilator. So I will press on OK. Please confirm if air comes out from the inspiratory circuit port. So from inspiratory, I can feel that air is coming out. So I will press on yes. Now we have to connect the exhalation valve port tube to this exhalation tube port, and similarly we have to connect the tube to the inspiratory port. Before performing the next test, we have to ensure that from inspiratory port to expiratory port, there should be no leakage. If leakage is present in the circuit, then sensor calibration test may be failed.
So we have to always ensure that there should be closed loop between inspiratory to expiratory port. So I have connected tubing between inspiratory, then I have connected test lung, and I have connected active exhalation wall to the expiratory port. Means closed loop between inspiratory and expiratory is fulfilled. So I will press on OK. Now we have to wait for few seconds for sensor calibration test. Once all tests are passed successfully, there will be a confirmation pop-up come on the screen that shows all tests are passed successfully. Now we have to press on done. The status of last preview check is shown in standby screen on the status option in the top bar. Here you can see all the tests are displayed here, the status of test and the date on which we have performed the preview check. If any of these tests is failed during preview check, in that condition ventilator will not be started. In that condition you have to contact authorized service provider for troubleshooting and servicing of ventilator for normal operation. In this video, we are going to learn how to set alarms. We will start the ventilation in volume control continuous mandatory ventilation. First, click on change mode. Select VCCMV. Set the parameters according to the patient's requirement. After setting parameters, press on accept. User has to compulsory set the alarms while selecting or switching to a new ventilation mode for safety reasons. While the user can also change the alarm values when the patient is being ventilated by tapping on the alarm profile button. Here we will set the alarms as per the set parameters. After setting the alarm profile, press on accept. Then start the ventilation. To test the alarm, set the ventilation parameters outside the lower and upper bounds of the alarm profile. For example, in the alarm profile, lower limit for tidal volume is 250. So we will set the tidal volume less than 250. Here you can see low tidal volume alarm is shown on the screen. That indicates your tidal volume is lower than your alarm profile. To stop this alarm, go in the alarm profile and change the lower limit for tidal volume as per the set volume. Then press on accept. To test high tidal volume alarm, press on alarm profile. Here you can see upper limit for tidal volume is 350 ml. Press on accept. Now set the tidal volume more than 350. Accept it. Here you can see alert for high tidal volume is shown on the screen. That shows your tidal volume is exceeding the alarm profile. Press on OK. Go in the alarm profiles and change the upper limit for tidal volume. And accept it.
to test low respiratory rate alarm, press on alarm profile. Here you can see the lower limit for respiratory rate is 9. Press on accept. In the set parameters, press on RR and set the RR less than 9. Then accept it. Here you can see low respiratory rate alarm is showing on the screen. Press on OK. Go in the alarm profiles and set the lower limit for RR less than set value and accept it. Press on accept. To test higher respiratory rate alarm, press on alarm profile. The upper limit for respiratory rate is 16. Press on accept. Now press on this set RR option and increase the RR more than 16 and accept it. Here you can see higher respiratory rate alarm is showing on the screen. That indicates respiratory rate exceeds the limit for alarm profile. Press on alarm profile and increase the upper limit for RR more than set RR value. Press on accept. To test low FiO2 alarm, press on alarm profile. Here you can see lower limit for FiO2 is 50. Press on accept. Now press on set value of FiO2. Keep this value lower than 50 and press on accept. Here you can see low FiO2 or gas cylinder failure alarm is coming on the screen. That indicates your FiO2 is not delivering to the patient, or oxygen line is failed, or oxygen sensor may be failed. In this condition, oxygen's mainline pressure may be low, or oxygen sensor is showing wrong readings. User have to ensure the main oxygen line pressure is proper, and user needs to perform pre-use check for proper working of oxygen sensor. To test low PEEP, that is positive end expirative pressure alarm, press on alarm profile. Here you can see lower limit for PEEP is 4 cm of water. Accept it. On the set parameters, keep the PEEP value lower than 4. Accept it. Here you can see low end expirative pressure alarm is showing on the screen. That shows PEEP value is lower than low value of alarm profile. To test high PEEP alarm, press on alarm profile. Upper limit for PEEP is 7 cm of water. Press on accept. Now set the PEEP value more than 7. Accepted. Here you can see high end expirative pressure alarm is showing on the screen. That indicates PEEP value is exceeding the upper limit of alarm profile. To test high inspiratory pressure alarm, press on alarm profile. Here you can see upper limit for pressure is 25. Press on accept. If inspiratory pressure goes beyond 25, it will give the high inspiratory pressure alarm. Here you can see on screen high inspiratory pressure alarm is coming. That shows your inspiratory pressure is exceeding the limit. To test patient disconnected alarm, I will simulate the condition by removing the patient tube from inspiratory port. Here you can see patient disconnected alarm is showing on the screen. When patient is restored, by closing the loop between inspiratory to expiratory port, it will show VT and VTE properly, that ensures the patient is properly connected and ventilation is proper. You can check the alarm history to see what are the alarms given by the ventilator. Whenever any alarm comes on the screen, yellow color indicates warning alarm and red color indicates danger alarm. In this video, we are going to learn do's and don't with NOCARC V310. First, we will start with do's. When user wants to set any ventilation mode, press on change mode, select any mode, accept the set ventilation window after setting the parameters. Always ensure you have set the alarm profile. When user wants to set PRVC mode, it may be a PRVC CMV, PRVC AC or PRVC SMV. Always ensure you have set upper limit for pressure. To set this value, press on this particular parameter and change the value. This value should be as per patient's requirement. Press on accept. When user wants to use NOCARC V310 in any invasive or non-invasive ventilation mode, always ensure the active exhalation valve is plugged in expiratory port. When user wants to keep V310 on standby, always ensure the display is turned off. To turn off the display, press and hold on the display button provided at right side of the screen. One prompt will be appear on the screen. Press on power off, press on OK. For normal operation of NOCARC V310, ventilator switch should be in switch on condition. Always do autoclave, reusable one, active exhalation valve. User can use active exhalation valve up to 10 times after doing autoclave. Always use non-vented mask for non-invasive ventilation. It will help to keep leakage as low as possible and proper ventilation. Always use sterile water in humidifier chamber for proper humidification. Now we are going to see don'ts for NOCARC V310. Never turn on aeroplane mode. Never mute the alarms. Never remove the silicone tube connected between active exhalation valve and the exhalation valve port. Never remove the knob cover provided on active exhalation valve and HME filter. Never use disposable active exhalation valve on multiple patients. Never remove the D-type charging cable connected with UI screen. Never operate any mode on default settings. Never use HME filters more than 72 hours. Never block air inlet. Never use same nasal cannula on multiple patients.